Let's take a deeper look into the contents of my transaction to Rusty. As we can see, a transaction has three sections. The metadata section contains some housekeeping data, a unique ID of the transaction, log time, and size. The input section contains a list of previously created UTXOs, as well as a proof that I am eligible of redeeming the UTXOs. This allows me to redeem them and use them to produce new outputs. And lastly, we have outputs. The output section contains a list of new UTXOs that will be sent to new addresses. Each of these values is accompanied with a script that locks the value away from everyone except the intended redeemer, who can provide a valid proof. Taking a deeper look into the transaction, we start with the metadata. The first piece of metadata is the hash of our transaction, or the unique ID of this transaction. We also get information here in the field VIN_SC, which stands for vector input size, or the number of input UTXOs being referenced in this transaction. We also have VOUT_SC, which stands for vector output size, or the number of new UTXOs being created. So in this example, I created this transaction with two UTXOs, and I sent them as one new UTXO to Rusty. And finally, we have version and log time. Version is a number specifying the version of the Bitcoin software that you're using. We'll talk more about log time later in this lecture. Now let's talk about input. Remember that in the metadata section, we have a unique ID for this entire transaction object they were talking about. These come in handy in the inputs, with each of the hashes you see being referenced to the unique IDs of previous transactions containing the relevant UTXOs that are being redeemed now. And we also have a reference to the index of the input in the previous transaction. 0 means the first input, 1 means the second, and so on. The script sig is the most important part of these inputs because they prove that you can redeem the associated UTXOs. Last but not least, the end product of our transaction is the outputs. You can see here in this particular transaction, we have only one output with a value of about 10 Bitcoin. Well, it looks like a large, really large number here because it's written in the smallest unit of Bitcoin, which is Satoshi. One Bitcoin can be converted to 100 million Satoshi, which means that a Bitcoin can be divisible to the 8th decimal place. The accompanying output address is a script that locks the transaction and makes it redeemable only by the specific proof that I specify in the transaction. And in our example, only after Rusty provides his proof can he unlock and spend the UTXOs.